tired of crying and sighing and denying his lies, and he was fed up. With this, Rulworth caved in, iced with sin, raised manifest projections with the smallest violin, playing to an audience with insecurities. Inside, rib cages of organs, plates with courage, wept in tears of returned guilt. When did this all become so hard? When did laughter become a challenge, a sign of danger, a doubt? A mask to isolate the islands he once wore under hand-me-down clothes, and that mask, he could hardly let oxygen seep through it. He never reached a moment of clarity where the images tattooed beside his eyelids became of images of my breaking thoughts, became of concepts like stop, no, and don't. Ambitions of idealism faded into his dreams of his own dreams, his own coffin, with no tears, and that light at the end of the tunnel, that light at the end of the tunnel. Disappeared to a less clear sphere of ice and caged birds. You see, there were two powerful but two underrated words. What if? You see, what if he had listened and paid attention? What if that first injection wasn't concealed perfection and it opened false trap doors disguised as stairways to heaven? No, disguised as stairways to heaven on earth. You see, this kid was weird. If life was full of hidden turns, he went straight. If life was about getting burned, he was made a slate. So what he did is that he got those big fingers that always put him back in, and he turned it into a fist. And like this, he believed. He achieved.